हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम सुनीता। वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल सीएस कॉर्नर। फ्रेंड्स, इफ यू आर न्यू टू माय चैनल एंड वाचिंग माय वीडियो फर्स्ट टाइम, प्लीज डू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल टू वॉच मोर वीडियोस ऑन कंप्यूटर टूल्स एंड टेक्नोलॉजीज। फ्रेंड्स, इन टूडेज वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू ग्रेडिंग पार्ट ऑफ गूगल क्लासरूम। Friends, in my previous video, I have already shown you how to create classroom and how to post assignment in classroom. In today's video, I am going to show you how to grade students on a particular assignment, and as well as I am going to show you one of the new feature of Google Classroom, that is rubric. Okay friends, so let's start. Friends, if you want to grade your students and if you want your student should see that marks, then you need to do one setting of your classroom. So for that, you need to click on this setting button and then just scroll down and go below to marking column. There is one part known as mark calculation. So overall mark calculation, by default it is no overall mark. So in this you can select total points or weighted by category. So let me show you what is total point. If I select total points, then the grading will be done depending on total points. So suppose you have given three assignments. Assignment number one is of 10 marks, assignment number two is of 20 marks, and assignment number three is of 20 marks. So total marks is 50 for all the assignment. So grading will be calculated on the basis of 50 marks. Okay, that is total points calculation. Another option we have as weighted by category. Now let me show you what is this category and how it is used. So for creating category, you need to click on add mark category. So I'm creating one category as presentation, and then I'm giving weightage to this presentation as 30%. It is in percent. Then create another category because leftover is 70%. Then I am giving assignment as 70%. Okay, so I have created two category. You can create the category you want depending on your need. So two category has been created. Now student, whatever mark student will get in presentation and in assignment, depending on that total overall marks calculation will be done. So I'm not taking weighted by category, I'm taking total points. Then next is very important part, that is show overall marks to student. Always enable this because so that student can see what marks they have obtained in a particular assignment. So if you enable this, then student can see their marks at their side. And finally, you need to click on save button. So I have clicked on save button. It is saving. So settings has been saved. Now next, what I will be doing, I will be showing you how to give grading now. So before giving grading, you need to change this setting. So for giving grading or for grading assignments, you need to go to marks column or a grading column. Friends, if you have seen my previous video, in that video I have shown how to create classroom and how to post assignment. So in my previous video, I have created 3-4 assignments and I have assigned that assignment to this enrolled student. Now you can see the student has submitted this 2 assignment and I have graded that student. What is this 91.67? Because I have taken total point overall calculation as a point wise. So this is of 100 marks and this is of 20 marks. Out of 120, the student has scored 110 marks. So percentage calculation is what? 91.67. So this is what this student percentage calculation. Currently I am having only one student enrolled to this class. So therefore class average is also 91.67. If you have more students, then this is going to differ. Now let me show you how to grade this. Before grading this, let's go to student side and let's see what I'm getting over there. So दिस इज वॉट माई क्लास एंड दिस इज माई टीचर नेम. आई विल बी क्लिकिंग ऑन दिस एंड देन आई विल बी गोइंग टू माई क्लास वर्क एंड देन यू कैन सी वॉट आई एम गेटिंग. आई एम गेटिंग वॉट इज कंप्यूटर सिक्योरिटी एंड इट हैज बीन ग्रेडेड. So I can see the question and I can see my marks also. So I have got 90 marks and my teacher has given me some comment like this. I'm at student side. So this is what my class, student class demo YouTube. And now we have to see the assignment or work done by students. So just click on this part. If you click on this, it is going to take you to the work done by student. So this is what name of student and what percentage student has scored. So total 4 assignment has been given to this student. Now in each assignment student has scored marks. So you can see 90 marks, 20 marks, and if you click on this detail security, computer security, you can see teacher name it is showing. And then if you click on view details button, it is going to take you details of that particular assignment. So this student has scored 90 marks. Teacher has given some comment over here. Now let's back to class again. Let me click on classwork. So I'll click on classwork again. I'll go to my assignment part. So this is what my next assignment. Now I'll go to next assignment, that is quizzes on security. You can see teacher has already graded, so it is showing me graded. Now I'll click on view assignment and then you can see it is showing me comment of teacher and then marks obtained by student in that particular assignment. In classwork, now I will be going to fourth assignment. So you can see that assignment is submitted but not graded. So now let's see, assignment has been submitted by student but no marks has been given by teacher yet. So using this assignment, I'm going to show you grading part through teacher side. So teacher has not yet evaluated this assignment. So now let's quickly go to grading part of teacher. We will come to teacher side. So this is what a grading at teacher side. Let me click on view assignment to evaluate that student. So it is opening the assignment. So it is showing me some message like comment add and then student detail. I need to just click on next button. It's showing me pop-up box. So just click on next button. You can see here is the assignment submitted by that students. So you can view the assignment, you can read the assignment and decide what marks you want to give. So this is what the comment part. You can read the assignment and you can give comment to a student. So for that, what you need to do, you need to click on this comment box and then select the portion wherever you want to give comment. So let me give comment to this part. So I've selected this part. Now I'm giving some comments over here. So whatever you feel is relevant for that particular topic, you can write comment over here. So I have given some comments and then I'm clicking on comment button. So you can see comment has been posted over here. So you can give comments wherever you want. So just scroll down and give the comments. Next part is comment bank. Here you can use most frequently comments which we give while assessing assignments. So just click on this comment add box and then add a frequent comments which you use for assessing your assignment. So I'm adding excellent, good as 2 comments. You can use or you can add whatever you want. So now you can see the 2 comments has been added. I can use this while assessing my assignments. So this was all related to comments. Okay, now this arrow is used for moving forward and backward. If I am having large students, I can go one by one and I can give comments to students. Now next part is grading part. So marks, I can give marks to student over here. So whatever marks I feel is suitable to that students, I can give. So I'm giving 9 marks to the student and I'm adding one comment, well done. And then let me click on post button to post this well done comment to students. And until I click on return button, my marks will not be given to student. So I need to click on return button. In this, we have one more option. If you want to return marks of all students, you can do that. So one by one, give marks to all the students. And then finally, you can click on return marks to all students. Or if you want, you can click on one by one return button. So it is asking me whether you want to return to marks to the student. You can click return button. So this marks has been given to that student. So now let's go back to student side and let's refresh this and let's see whether the student gets marks or not. You can see comment is appearing over here. Well done. Now I'm refreshing this page. Okay, so after reloading, I'm getting marks also. So marks, comment, as well as you can see it is showing me part graded also. Previously it was showing me handed in late. So grading is done for this student. Now you can see our teacher side, it has also been reflected. Marks is 9, whatever marks you have given. It is showing me percentage also. Let me refresh this to get whether it has actually reflected or not the marks which I have assigned or the percentage. So now you can see it is showing me percentage also. As compared to the previous percentage, now it is showing me a different percent. So depending on the marks, percentage is automatically calculated. So this was all related to grading part. You can give marks and you can return that marks to students, and then you can calculate percentage also. So now I'm going to show you a next and very important feature of Google Classroom. That feature is known as rubric feature. You can use rubric to grade and give feedback to your students. Suppose you have created some assignment and you have given some marks to that assignment. Now you want to show marks bifurcation to your student. So for that you can go for rubric. So rubric is used to give feedback to students. Now let me show you how to do that. So just click on classwork and then we'll create a new assignment. So to give rubric, we have not created any rubric. So first of all, we'll create rubric. So for that, click on create. So classwork, click on create button, create new assignment. So I'm going to give a new assignment, cloud computing presentation. So this is what my assignment name. Now let me give some description of this assignment. So I'm giving description as maximum slides 10. Okay, so this is what description. Now I need to do other settings also. So over here I can create or I can give settings. So you can give category and then category. Since I'm not using category part, so you can leave it default. And then you can give the marks which you want to assign. Okay, so whatever marks you want to give for assignment, you can give. I'm giving 20 marks for this assignment. Then you can select the date whichever you want to give submission date for this assignment. So I'm giving date as 27, and then you can select time also if you want. Then important part is what topic, in which topic this assignment should go. Now click on then rubric button. It is asking me to reuse the rubric or create a new rubric. So what I will be doing, I will be clicking on create rubric button. So this is what the page where you can create rubric. So now it asks me what, so create a rubric. So it is asking me criterion title, so I need to provide criteria. So what is criteria? For example, I have given assignment as making a PPT. In that, I want to give criteria as a topic selection and content of a slides. So that will become my criteria. And then in that criteria, I can divide whether it is moderate, good, or excellent. So I'm giving criteria as topic selection. So topic selection is going to be my one criteria. So I'm giving title as topic selection. Now next, I need to give description of this criteria topic selection. So you can give description related to your topic. So I'm giving description as relevant, then the marks will be provided. And then you need to provide some detail over here. Now next we have points. So what we have to give in points, if student is selecting topic proper not relevant, then I can give point as 2 and value as moderate. Then I can write some description that not relevant. Then you can click on this plus sign to create next point. So if student is selecting little bit relevant topic, then I'm going to give score as good and value point value as 5. Then lastly, what I will be doing, if student is selecting a excellent topic or a very very relevant topic, then I'm going to give full marks to that students, that is point as 10. And then I'm going to give excellent, and then description is what topic is relevant. So this way, whenever you are returning assignment to students, and if student got 5 marks, student will come to know whether the topic was relevant or not relevant, or why the student got that much marks. So now next, what I will be doing, I will be creating few more criteria. So next, my criteria is what slide contents. So I'm giving slide content as criteria, and then I'm giving description to that slide. So evaluation is based on the content of a slide. So you can create new criteria, or you can use existing criteria also. So here we have option as duplicate. So if you click on duplicate criteria, so that criteria is going to be duplicated, and then you can add or change value according to your requirement or your need. Now since I have duplicated the criteria, so what I will be doing, I will be deleting this criteria and I will be modifying value over here. So instead of topic selection, it will be slide content, and then give description also, and then below also label value, and rest part also you need to modify. So instead of now content relevant, I'm giving slide contents or relevant content, something like that. So as per your assignment, you can change all this value. So now it's done. Slide content and topic selection. You can see here we have total 20 marks. 10 marks is for topic selection, 10 marks is for slide creation. So overall 20 marks. Now click on save button. So this rubric will get saved. So now you can see this presentation, this assignment is having a rubric. Now I will be clicking on this create button to give what assignment, PowerPoint assignment. So slide, create slide, and then a slide will be created. Here I'm going to be named to my slide as cloud computing so I'm giving name as cloud computing presentation. So Google slide will be created, and then I have to do settings, few settings also, so that for each student a slide will be created. So you can see, instead of only view file, what I'm giving third option, that create copy for each student. So for each student copy will be created, and then last part is what, assign. So a assignment has been assigned to students with rubric. Now I will be going to student part, and let's student submit that assignment. So you can see here we have in cloud topic we have assignment cloud computing presentation along with rubric. And now let me click on view assignment so that I can complete that assignment. So handed, and it is showing assigned and handed over here. So now let's go back to student side, refresh the page, and we'll go to classwork, or we can see from here also cloud computing presentation has come. It is showing me 20 marks. Along with that marks, it is showing me rubric part also. So student will come to know what they have to prepare, and according to what marks criteria they will be getting the marks. So here each and every part is shown in details. So rubric can help student to prepare their content well. So now student can submit their assignment. So let student submit the assignment, then we can see how rubric works. At student side, let me add few contents over here. So I am going to type something related to cloud computing. So cloud computing platform, I'm typing this. Okay, I'm done with the contents. Now I'm not adding any more content, I'm just closing it. As a student side, I will be clicking on submit button. So this assignment will be turned in or submitted to the teacher. So let's go to the teacher side and let's grade this student so that student can see rubric part and we can also understand how this rubric works. So let me reload this page. So I'm at teacher side, I'm getting handed in 1 and assigned as 0 since student has submitted the assignment. So you can see a PPT has been created for that student, a slide has been created. Similarly, you have more student, that many slide is going to come at your side, at teacher side. You can view the slide and then you can grade that students. Slides are loaded. Now what I can do, I can grade this student using the rubric. So from this I can select any of this which I feel. So topic selection, I'm selecting as excellent because it comes under cloud computing. Next, what I'm taking content of a slide as good. I'm not so much impressed with the content, so I'm taking content, slide content as good. So you can see a marks has been calculated automatically, 15 marks. So topic selection is 10 marks. Then, and now finally I will be clicking on return button. Then click on return. So this 15 marks has been given to this student. So let's go to student side, and now just see this, what has come, a beautiful part. Now student can see in out of 15 where they got 10 marks and in which part they got 5 marks, or overall what is the bifurcation of the marks which they have received. So excellent and then good, total comes as 15. So topic selection 10 marks and slide content 5 marks. In this way, student can come to know where they have to improve or what other contents they can add or how they can make their presentation good. So this was all about Rubrik and Google Classroom. Friends, start using Google Classroom for managing your classwork, as well as it reduces manual work also. And Rubrik is new feature which can give feedback to students, and student will also like it. So whatever you were doing manually, everything can be done using Google Classroom. I'm using it for managing my all classes. So you must also try and let me know in comment box whether you like Google Classroom or not. Friends, if you have not seen my previous video, you can click on the link which is given in description box. I have given link of all my videos. You can click on the links and you can see my previous videos. Thank you to all those who have watched my video till end. Friends, if you have not subscribed my channel yet, please do subscribe it and share my videos with your friends, comment, and do let me know whether you like my video in comment box. Thank you. Take care. Bye bye. See you in my next video.